ओम शांति। मॉर्निंग मुरली, 29th जून। स्वीट लेटर ऑफ बाप दादा फॉर स्वीट स्वीट चिल्ड्रन। एसेंस, स्वीट चिल्ड्रन, यू शुड नॉट डिबेट टू मच विद एनीवन। स्वीट चिल्ड्रन, यू शुड नॉट डिबेट टू मच विद एनीवन। जस्ट गिव द इंट्रोडक्शन ऑफ द फादर टू एवरीवन। क्वेश्चन, द अनलिमिटेड फादर हैज स्टेप चिल्ड्रन एज वेल एज रियल चिल्ड्रन। हु आर रियल चिल्ड्रन? The unlimited father has stepchildren as well as real children. Who are real children? Answer, those who follow Baba's Shrimat. Those who follow Baba's Shrimat, who have a true Rakhi of purity tied, who have the faith that they will surely take the unlimited inheritance. Children with such faith in the intellect are real children. Step children are those who follow the dictates of their own minds. Sometimes they have faith, sometimes doubt. They even break the promise they make. The duty of worthy children is to listen to and follow all of the father's direction. The duty of worthy children is to listen to and follow all of the father's directions. The first direction fathers give is, sweet children, now have a true Rakhi of purity tied and finish any impure attitude. Now have a true Rakhi of purity tied and finish any impure attitude. Song, awaken, O brides, awaken, the new age is about to come. Om Shanti, you children understand the meaning of the song? The new word is the new age and the old word is the old age. The new word follows after the old word. The new word is created by only the Supreme Father, the Supreme Soul. So whether you say Ishwar or Prabhu, you definitely have to call him by his name. If you just say Prabhu, with whom do you have yoga? Whom do you remember? Human beings say that he does not have a name, form, place of abode or time. Oh ho, but his name Shiva is well known in Bharat. The one for whom Shivratri is celebrated is the one who is called the father. It is only when you have the father's introduction that your intellects can have yoga with him. It is pointless to debate too much with anyone. It is pointless to debate too much with anyone. First of all, you have to give the introduction of the unlimited father to everyone. Which human word does he create? How and when? From the beginning of the golden age to the end of the iron age. You continue to meet worldly fathers. But it is always the father from beyond who is remembered. He is the father who resides in the supreme abode. Don't think that heaven is the supreme abode. The golden age is a place here. The supreme abode is where the supreme father, the supreme soul and we soul resides. Since the father of all souls is the creator of the golden age, why do his children not have the kingdom of heaven? Yes, we definitely did receive the sovereignty of the golden age at some time. There was a new world and a new age, but it is now the old world and the old age. The father created heaven. It has now become hell. Who created hell? And when was it created? Maya Ravan created hell. It is very easy to give this knowledge to the residents of Bharat. Because it is the residents of Bharat who burn EFG of Ravan. However, they don't understand the meaning of that. All the devotees remember God. All the devotees remember God, but because of not knowing him, they call him omnipresent. They say that he is beyond name and form. They say that he is limitless, that you cannot reach the end of him. This is why all humans have lost hope and become slack. They had to become slack. Only then can there be the time for Baba to come and create heaven. The father says, I have now come again. The devotees definitely receive their reward from God. It is here that God has to come to give the reward, because all are impure. No one impure can go there, which is why I have to come. People also invoke me. The devotees need God. Now what will they receive from God? Liberation and liberation in life. He will not give liberation in life to everyone. It is those who make effort that are the ones who will receive it. Will all the billions of souls receive the inheritance? Baba is asking, will all the billions of souls receive the inheritance? When people come to you, tell them, the Father is the creator of heaven. We are experienced. We don't search for God now. He comes at his own time. We searched very hard before, but were not able to find him. We went on pilgrimages. We did a lot of penance and chanting and searched a great deal, but we did not find him. He has to come at his own time from the supreme region. The deities of the original eternal religion have to take 84 births. The five castes are famous. There is now the clan of Shudras and the clan of Brahmins. You have to explain the different clans. The castes are shown in variety form image, but people don't know about the Brahmin clan. So the first introduction you should give is that the Father is the creator of heaven, and that you are the Brahma Kumars and Kumaris. It is only when the Father comes and creates Brahman that you can then become deities. There is the name Prajapita, father of people. Prajapita, Brahma. Brahmans are created through the mouth of Brahma. The father of Brahma is Shiva Baba. And so you are the family of God. Just as there are the Kriplani and Vaswani families, in the same way you are his God's family. You are his children. True Brahmins are those who have made a promise of purity. All of you are his children, but there are some among you who are real children and others who are stepchildren. The real ones have a Rakhi of purity tied. There is also the festival of Rakhi. All of these things belong to the confluence age. Dashera, the burning of Ravan, is also a festival of the confluence age. Diwali comes immediately after destruction. Everyone's light is ignited. In the Iron Age, everyone's light is extinguished. The father is also called the master of the garden and the boatman. Brahma, Vishnu or Shankar cannot be called the master of the garden or boatman. The father comes into his garden to look at his children. Some of them are roses, some are jasmine, and some are lilies. Each one has the fragrance of knowledge. So all of you are now becoming flowers from thorns. This is a forest of thorns. There is a lot of fighting and quarreling because all are atheists and orphans. They don't have the Lord and Master, the one who can give them directions and make them into those who belong to the Lord and Master. No one knows the Lord and Master. Therefore, the Lord and Master definitely has to come. So the Father comes and makes you into those who belong to the Lord and Master. Human beings desire to have one religion, one kingdom, but their also has to be purity. There was the one religion in the golden age, but it is now the land of sorrow. You have now been transformed to the Brahman clan. You will then go into the deity clan and not come into this impure world. The land of Bharat is the highest. If the Gita had not been falsified, who would even ask about Bharat? They go to the temples of Shiva. They are temples to the Unlimited Father, because the Father is the only one who bestows salvation on all. He comes and makes orphan belong to the Lord and Master. No one except the Father can explain these things. All others are those who teach devotion. There is no question of knowledge. The ocean of knowledge, the one who grants salvation, is only one. Human beings cannot be gurus to grant salvation. They call those who teach skills gurus. But such gurus cannot bring salvation to the entire world. Even though people say that they receive peace from the holy man, etc., but it is temporary. Sannyasis say that the happiness of heaven is like the dropping of a crow. Therefore, whatever peace is received from the sannyasis is also like the dropping of a crow. They cannot give liberation. The bestower of liberation and liberation in life is only the one Father. People all have a lot of love for Shri Krishna, but they don't know him fully. The Father says, in the golden age there was the land of Krishna, and it is now the land of Kans, devils. The Father now comes and once again creates the land of Krishna. Then after half a cycle, it becomes the kingdom of Ravan, hell. For half a cycle, there is happiness, and for a half a cycle, there is sorrow. The time of happiness is greater, but the play of happiness and sorrow continues. It is called the word cycle or the play of victory and defeat. Sannyasis think that they can attain eternal liberation, but no one can attain that. No one understands the significance of this. No one except the Father can grant liberation or liberation in life. You are now establishing your own kingdom. Just look, there is nothing here but sorrow all around. We are now creating heaven with the Father's help. And we will then become the masters of heaven and rule it. All others will be sent to the land of liberation, and they will come at their own times. Then when they do come and down, they will first have happiness and then sorrow. On the path of devotion, they turn rosaries and do penance and chanting, etc. People say that you should only remember the one, but you have to shed body consciousness for that. No one, however, sheds body consciousness. The Father says, now all have to return. The Father only talks to the children. Among the children, there are some who are real children and some who are stepchildren. Stepchildren are those who don't have a rakhi of purity tied. Real children have the faith that they will definitely claim the inheritance. However, there are some who fail. Some are weak, some are strong, all are number wise. Strong ones are those who bring their wives and children as well. A strong one will make others the same as himself. A stork and a swan cannot live together. It is a big responsibility for the Father. To make everyone pure is the Father's task. This is why the Father says both wheels should go together. If the wife and husband go together, everything works out fine. Come, let us both have the bond of purity tied together. We will definitely now become pure and take the inheritance from the Father. If you are the children of Brahma, you are brothers and sisters, and there cannot be criminal assault. Godly law says that they cannot indulge in vice. Now the father says the attitude of drinking and giving poison should break. The attitude of drinking and giving poison should break. We will give each other the nectar of knowledge to imbibe. We will also claim the inheritance of heaven from the father. The duty of worthy children is to obey their father. Those who don't obey him are unworthy. A father would definitely hesitate before giving an inheritance to unworthy children. You are Brahmins, the ones who are becoming deities. So you should make your wife drink the nectar of knowledge in the same way that a little child knows his hold and when giving him his medicines. Baba is saying, so you should make your wife drink the nectar of knowledge in the same way that a little child's nose is held when giving him medicines. Ask your wife, do you believe that your husband is your God and your guru? In that case, I will definitely bring you salvation. A husband can very soon make his wife equal to himself. But a wife cannot make her husband equal to herself as quickly. And this is why there is assault against innocent ones. Daughters have to endure a lot of beating. Even the government is not able to protect you. They say, we are not able to do anything. The father says, children, follow Shrimat and you will become the masters of heaven. If you become unworthy, you lose the inheritance. Children, outside, take limited inheritance from their father. Whereas the worthy children here take the unlimited inheritance from the unlimited father. Here it is the land of sorrow. You should not wear any gold hair. You should not wear any gold hair because you are beggars at this time. In the next birth you will receive palaces of gold studded with jewels. You understand that you are now receiving the inheritance for 21 births from the Father. On the path of devotion, I only give you the return of your faith. On the path of devotion, I only give you the return of your faith. People don't understand where the Krishna soul is or where the Guru Nanak soul is. You understand how everyone has become Tamopradhan by taking birth and rebirth. All of that happens in the word cycle. All have to become Tamopradhan. In the end, the father comes and takes everyone back home. Acha, to the sweetest, beloved, long lost and now found children, love, remembrance and good morning from the mother, the father, Bab Dada. The spiritual father says namaste to the spiritual children. And who spiritual children says namaste, good morning to our sweetest spiritual father. Essence for dharana, you now have to have the bond of purity tied. Shed body consciousness and transform impure attitudes. Shed body consciousness and transform impure attitudes. Follow the father's Shrimat and become a worthy child. You have to imbibe the nectar of knowledge and also give it to others. Take in fragrance of knowledge and become a fragrant flower. Today's blessing, feel Baba's hand on your head and take blessing. May you stay free from obstacles with the double lock of accurate remembrance and service and become feeling proof. May you stay free from obstacles with the double lock of accurate remembrance and service and become feeling proof. Baba is saying, whatever doors are there for the Maya to enter, put a double lock of remembrance and service on them. If Maya comes, even when you do stay in remembrance and do service, there isn't definitely something missing in your remembrance and service. If Maya comes, even when you do stay in remembrance and do service, there is then definitely something missing in your remembrance and service. Real service is that in which there is no selfishness. If there is not altruistic service, then the lok must be loose and remembrance also has to be powerful. When you have such a double lok, you will become free from obstacles. And you will then be beyond any wasteful feeling of why and what. You will become free from obstacles and you will then be beyond any wasteful feeling of why and what and become a feeling-proof soul. Slogan, having a balance of love and power enables you to experience success. Having a balance of love and power enables you to experience success. Om Shanti. Now invaluable elevated versions of Mateshwari Ji. To take knowledge is actually a matter of a second. But if people were to understand it in 1 second, then it would take them a second to understand their own religion and also know that in reality. They are souls who are embodiments of peace. And children of God, to understand this is a matter of second, but in order to have this faith, there is no need for them to do Hatha Yoga, chant mantra, or make all other spiritual endeavor that they do. Simply understand your original form. Simply understand your original form. For what are we making all this effort? It is explained that all the effort we make is just for this one little thing. Just as you have to create your practical life, so you have to remove body consciousness completely. Truly, it is definitely requires a lot of hard work to be stable in the stage of the soul consciousness and to imbibe divine virtues. We stay careful about this at every moment and in every step. When we are careful about Maya, then no matter how many situations come in front of us, they will not be able to oppose us. Maya opposes us when we have forgotten ourselves. There is this little margin for us to create our practical life. There is this little margin for us to create our practical life, but otherwise knowledge is a matter of a second. Knowledge is a matter of a second. Acha, Om Shanti. Thank you, Baba and Mama.